All right, we'll get back to Tampa in a second. First, the last 30 seconds in Jersey. The Devils up on Chicago by a goal as Brodeur goes for the record.
Played along behind by Oduya. Along for Patrick Elias. Lobs one high in the air. Glove down by Bufflin. Turnaround play doesn't work. Keeps dumping it in. 12 to go. Johnny Oduya flipped it back off. And it went out of play. Deflected out of play. An offensive zone faceoff for Chicago with 8.9 to go.
Whoa, what a finish to this hockey game. I got to tell you, stay tuned. Don't even go anywhere when this game ends. If Marty Brodeur does get the win, you're going to see something that's a first here with the New Jersey Devils. After he celebrates with his team, he's immediately going to go to Steve Cangelosi, where the Zamboni is. We're going to have a camera there. And then the neat part is we're going to pipe in Marty's interview into this entire arena so everybody can enjoy what Marty has to say about how he feels about getting the record. But Doc, you think I jinxed him by, I hope not, 8.9 seconds to go. I had to do that promotion, but at the same time, it's something that you always get nervous about doing because Marty Brodeur knows in 8.9 seconds, a lot could happen.
92 years, 613 goaltenders have played at least a period in the NHL. Some of them 2 decades. Some of them did not wear masks, had only a baseball fielder's glove to catch with. Some wore crude masks of plaster, later fiberglass, bird cages. Some were plain white. More had splashes of color. One had a horn set and a hooked tail at the bottom for years. It's been changed a little, but the goaltender who wears it has not. 8.9 to go, Taves against Madden. False start, now it's one. Taves flopped it on back. Barker kept it, shot one, blocked down in front. Oh, and a pad stop made by Brodeur. Cleared back along, not out. One more by Barker, blocked. And Marty Brodeur is the winningest goaltender in the NHL. Shared as they often are in other sports, but this is a first. I've not seen this done before, have you?
No, leave it to Marty to come up with something creative to celebrate this moment. There's his brother, Denny Jr., straight up getting every shot. And remember, folks, never ever in the history of the National Hockey League has this moment ever occurred before. And look at the players, they're not leaving. Nobody in this building is. Oh, this is, and then Doc, for Marty to need that save right at the end of the game, a really nice one to put the finishing touches on it. I tell you, that blocker hand's getting a workout. That's not easy netting to cut. It's very thick, and he's going to take that whole net. I like it. I hope I get a piece of it. No. Danny Senior.
It's meant to stop pucks as he is. Pucks are not meant to go through that. That's why that's tough.
Jeff Van Der Beek on your left. Lou Lamoriello in the middle. And John Caron, who's seen it all and been with Marty through the good times and the bad, also up there enjoying this moment.
Well, when he breaks the shutout record, maybe a chainsaw.
Or just take the whole net. Oh, my, this is sweet. The significant thing of that netting also, Doc, it's the same netting that Patrick Elias passed to Brian Gionta, and the goal was scored. So it's also the netting that stopped Elias's record-setting point total. Or set his point total, rather. That's a good backup. Kevin Weeks sitting there helping his buddy Marty Brodeur. Scotty Clemenson somewhere. We wish you were here, Scotty. You've been part of this season.
All right, that is the scene from Jersey. Lots more, of course, on SportsCenter and during the intermissions of our second game. But for now, back to Gord Miller and Pierre Maguire in Tampa Bay.